We give you glory. We give you honor. We acknowledge your lordship. We acknowledge that you are the King. You are the Lord of all. You stand alone. Nothing makes you complete. You are complete by yourself. You don't need anything to make you who you are. We bless your great name. We magnify you. Our hearts magnifies you. Our hearts blesses your name. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you adoration. There is none else like you, Lord. Today we stand before you. You have searched our hearts and you have known us. You know our sitting down and you know when we rise. You know our thoughts before we think. What a God you are. This far, you brought us by your mighty end. You are the keeper of all that trust in you. In you, we cannot be disappointed. You said you will not leave us. You will not fail us. Even at this point, we are convinced you are with us. We give you praise. We give you glory. Thank you for your mercies that are new every morning. And your grace that is abundant. We thank you for showing us the token of goodness by giving us today and causing us to stand before your presence. We give you praise and glory. For the short time we have to share your word, Lord, I ask you that your grace abound. Let your word come with clarity, with precision, with conviction, and with power. Let your people record testimonies and miracles, even as you promised in this service. And let your name be glorified. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. 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 We may take our seats. Glory to Jesus. Exodus chapter 3. Let's look at chapter 4 and then we will come later to look at chapter 3. Exodus chapter 4 and verse 17. And thou shalt take, God is speaking to Moses, and thou shalt take this rod in thine hand, wherewith thou shalt do signs. Give us NIV. Let's see how NIV is putting it. But take this staff in your hand, so you can perform miraculous signs with it. Today I want to share with us on a very basic and simple message. The God of miracles. The God of miracles. As we teach and preach, we are persuaded that this service is not just about taking notes. This message and this service is meant to trigger the performance of the message itself. So I believe after this message, anyone that will dare believe God will experience miracles. you want to see the intentions of God, listen to what he is saying part time. The speaking of God part time is an expression of his intention. If you want to know what God has in mind to do, if you want to know what God is intending to do, listen to what he is saying part-time, because the speaking of God is the expression of his intention. The God of miracles. Please open your heart to this message and expect a miracle after this service. Expect a miracle. The God of the Bible, write this, the God of the Bible is a miracle working God. The God of the Bible God, the God we know from the Bible is a miracle God. We have seen it from our covenant fathers to history. We have seen him as the miracle working God. God would wait for a man, our father of faith, Abraham, until he is 100 years, and then he gives him a son, a miracle. He wanted to teach us through our covenant fathers that he is a God of miracles. We have few believers that believe in miracles today. They talk about it, but they don't really believe it. It is one thing to talk about something. It is another thing to believe something. It is not enough to talk about miracles. You must see God and believe God for miracles. I'm so persuaded. I am so convinced. I am so confident that after this service, anyone that will come into contact with this message and believe what God has sent us to say today, you will reckon miracles. The God of the Bible is a miracle working God. Our Christian life should be a life of miracles. We have not been called to adore an ordinary life. The Bible says we have been called from darkness into a kingdom. And in this kingdom, one of the characteristics of this kingdom we have been called into is a miraculous kingdom. God cannot call us from darkness into an ordinary life. That is not our God. That is not the God of the Bible. Our Christian life should be littered with miracles. It should be a miracle life. The Bible says, and these signs shall follow they that believe. These signs shall follow they that believe. A believing life, a life of a believer, is supposed to be a life of miracles. And these signs shall follow. Not the believers following the signs. It is the signs. It's the signs are supposed to be a part of the life of a believer. And these signs will accompany. Miracles are supposed to be your companion. And these signs will accompany those who believe. So Christian life, the difference between Christianity and other religions is what I'm talking to you now. Not doctrines. Every religion has doctrines. It is only Christianity that it introduces us to a life of miracles. And what are miracles? The deeds of God that would not have happened otherwise. It is not a miracle if it would have been done the human way. If it would have been done by human way, human strength, human ability, it is not a miracle. A miracle is a miracle because it would not have been done any other way apart from the way God has done it. It's supposed to be a part of us. Our God is not an imaginary God. Our God is a real God. It's a true God. It's a living God. It's a powerful God. Other gods don't speak, don't act. They are just the making of the hands of men. But our God is the creator that was not created. Our Christian life should be a miracle life. Please hear it this. There has never been a time when we need to experience and walk in the miraculous like now. And I'll show you why. There's never been a dispensation. There's never been time in history when the miraculous was so necessary like our time. I'm telling you, whether you are in business, whether you are a career person, whether you are into ministry, there has never been a time before that the miraculous is needed like our time. And I'll prove to you from the scriptures why. Hear this. Miracles are not for fun. I want to give you four reasons why miracles are so needed in our time. And I believe as I'm talking to you, something is forming in your spirit that will give birth to miracles. Number one, we need the miraculous in our day because of the renewed and accelerated efforts of the devil against humanity. When you know you are running out of time, you engage your best. Your best speed, your best weapons, your best strategies. When you know you have limited time. The Bible shows us in Revelation chapter 12, verse 12. Him, the devil, knowing that he has short time. Therefore rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them, O to the inhabitants of the earth. You see, some are told to rejoice, and others are told to mourn. Those in heaven are told rejoice because the devil has no activities here anymore. There is nothing he can do here. He has no accommodation here. He has no operations here, but to those who are on the earth, that is where we are. But to those who are on the earth and the sea, for the devil has come down to you having great wrath because he knows that he has short time. The shorter the time, the more the intensity of his work. The closer we get to to the end, the more the works of Satan will be accelerated. Therefore, you need the miraculous. Let me tell you, the way the devil is working now is not the way he was working 1,000 years ago. He has accelerated. Why? He knows he has short time. He knows some people, if he will not get them now, he will lose them forever. He knows if he cannot torment you at this point, he will lose you permanently. Therefore, his efforts are accelerating. His works are accelerating. Are we not? Look, there are certain things we are seeing today that were not even in the minds of people 20, 30 years ago. The shorter the time, the more the effort. The shorter the time, the greater the speed. The devil is not going slow the way some Christians are going slow. Satan is not relaxed the way many Christians are relaxed. He knows he has short time. He has to put all his effort. He has to engage the all of the speed. Today we are experiencing and seeing in the news and all over the place things that were not unheard of many some years ago. Why? Our enemy knows the time is short. So he is accelerating his efforts. He's more committed than before. He is in the systems. He's not only interested with people's lives. He knows one of the ways to affect people's lives is to get himself in the systems and structures of life. Some of the things you see happening in the society is not the people doing them. It's Satan. I'm telling you. The hatred to the truth, the hatred to the church, the hatred to anything called good can tell you that he is working more than he was working before. That's why we need the miraculous. There are certain things in life at this point you cannot combat them by any other way. It has to be the miraculous. There are some problems today in the society that there is no other way they can be dealt with unless by the miraculous. Number two. Because of the complexity of challenges today, we need the miraculous. The challenges our fathers were dealing with are not the challenges we are dealing with today. The world is becoming complex. Challenges are becoming complex. Diseases are becoming complex. Today, you hear a girl of 12 years, they have diabetes. Those things were not there before. Terminal diseases. When I was growing up as a kid, it was strange to attend the funeral of young people. Today, young people, by research, they are saying that young people are dying more than the old people. Why? The challenges are becoming complex as we get to the close of the age. You need something higher than the complexities of life. It is called the miraculous. And right now, in the name of the risen Christ, may you receive the impartation to walk in the miraculous. It's not for preachers. This is not for preachers. And these signs shall follow they that believe, not they that preach. Believers, not preachers. The miraculous is not for preachers, it's for believers. Can you lift up your hand and say, Lord, I need a miracle? Do you believe what you're saying? Charlie, challenges are changing. The challenges our grandfathers were confronted with, today they have become complex. Last month I was praying, and the Lord told me, you see, people are talking a lot about Corona. Corona is just the beginning. I was shocked. It shook my heart to know that the thing that has shut down the world is the beginning. If the shutdown of the world is the beginning, listen, no one can pray away the prophetic agenda. You can only pray for exemption. Whatever is in the program of the prophetic, there is no prayer that can be prayed to stop it. For instance, earthquakes, there is no prayer that will stop earthquakes. They will keep coming. There's no prayer that will stop plagues. There's no prayer that will stop all these things that have been prophesied as some of the signs of the age. The only thing that we can pray is for the exemption. It is happening, but I am exempted. And one of the strategies, one of the system of exemption is the miraculous. You remember the children of Israel? God said, I'll do signs to push the enemy in Egypt. But in Goshen, what will be happening in other places will not be happening there. If there is darkness in Egypt, in Goshen there will be no darkness. If people are dying in Egypt, in Goshen people will be okay, alive. That is our heritage as the children of God. The world may become what it is becoming, but we are assured by the miraculous we shall be exempting. And I speak to somebody that is watching now. No matter how weakened the world is becoming, no matter what is happening out there, the complexity of life, the complexity of challenges, you are exempted by the miraculous. Yeah. You can't pray against prophetic agendas. Jesus is saying these things certainly will happen. So you can't pray against them, but you can exempt yourself. You can exempt your children. You can exempt your family. And one of the systems of exemption is the miraculous. When others will be dying, when the firstborns of the Egyptians are dying, not even a dog will die in the camp of the Jews. I speak to you in the name of Jesus. Because of the complexities of the earth that is destroying marriages and families, you are exempted by the miraculous. May your family experience miracles that will preserve you when others are dying. That's the difference between born again and not born again. He said you shall return and see the difference between the righteous and the wicked, between he that serves God and he that doesn't. There must be a difference. And Jesus said, I am not praying that you take them out of the world. We are in the world, but not of the world. That is to say, what is eating the world should not come to our camp. And how will we be exempted? The miraculous. Lift up your hand and shout miracles. Shout like you believe it, miracles. Number three. I'm just enjoying my message. One of the reasons why we need the miraculous in our day more than any other time is that life has become and is becoming more difficult in our time than any other time. Life is becoming difficult. Life is becoming very difficult. That is the reality. That is the reality on the ground. You see, after confessing by faith, you know life is difficult on the ground.
there. You know, life is difficult on the ground. It is not the way it used to be. Yeah. Life is difficult. Some people, when we began the year, January, they never knew that by March they will have lost their income. They will have lost their salary. They will have lost their job. They did not know that. Look at what has happened in the world in the last 3 months. Just 3 months. Life is more difficult in our time than in the past. But as for us who fear the Lord, a son of righteousness will rise for us. It is not okay. It is not in order. It is not godly for the godly to suffer with the ungodly. It is not correct. Life is getting more difficult these days. One of the spirit that is prevalent in the world today is the spirit of uncertainties. You don't know what tomorrow will. Today is corona. You don't know after corona what will come. Uncertainties. Nobody is sure of what is coming tomorrow. Nobody is sure of what will happen by September. They are only working with the speculations. That is one of the common signs that the world is living under uncertainties, speculations. The Bible says, and there will, in the last days, there will be rumors. A rumor is something that is not confirmed. And the devil loves where there are rumors. Uncertainties. Talk to an average person. They will tell you they are not sure what will happen next month. Talk to an average person. They are not sure what awaits for them in their careers. If they are career people, if they are business people. The businesses that have been stable over the years, all of a sudden destabilized. Stuck because our time, their life is more difficult than in the past. That's why you need the miraculous. I pray for you that every step of the way you will experience miracles that will neutralize the difficulties of life that are there in our time. Some difficulties, you can't clear them in any other way by a miracle. Life. Please look at somebody next to you if you are sitting next to a person and ask them whether they are experiencing some difficulties. Yeah, not whether they are demon possessed. No, they are not demon possessed. But difficulties. You know, difficulty is not a demon. And we need to become real now. And you see, you cannot confront issues until you confront yourself. This is how things are. This is the reality. The miraculous does not deny the reality. The miraculous raises you above the realities that don't favor you. In Egypt, and yet not suffering what the Egyptians are suffering. In Egypt, and not die when the Egyptians are dying. In Egypt, and yet they have water. When every water has turned into blood. You see, this is good news for you. That the, can I tell you? you something? God has organized life that despite the difficulties of your dispensation, you should be doing well in the midst of difficulties. Yeah. As a matter of fact, God uses bad times to bless the people. His people. You remember Isaac? And there was famine in the days of Isaac, beside the famine that was there in the days of his father Abraham. In the same season, the Bible says, and Abraham sowed the seed during drought, bad times, difficult time. He sowed the seed. What happened? He harvested 100-fold because God blessed him. Others are borrowing. The man is harvesting. Bad time to harvest, but he is harvesting. I decree in the name of Jesus, this corona season, may this season leave you with something that will always remind you about the faithfulness of God. I'm very happy that some people are getting this. When the economy is shut down, when the businesses are not doing well, when there are curfews and everything, we are still dedicating things for believers. That is our God. This season will not leave you this way. No dry season should leave believers dry. Every dry season is an opportunity for God to show his people that he is above seasons. He is above situations. He is above circumstances. He is above the natural things. Yeah. God will bless you this corona time. We think that after corona is gone, you almost call it corona something. You almost call it corona miracle. Yeah. That is my prayer for you. That this season of corona, as it is going, it will leave you with things that will constantly remind you your God is not a season of God. Your God loves to bless when time is not favoring. Hear this. If God favors you, even if favor doesn't favor you, things will still work in your favor. How can God make a... And look at what the Bible is saying. Look at verse 13. Okay, let's start from verse 12 here. Then Isaac sowed in that land and received the same year. God does not want you to think that the same year when there is drought, when there are difficulties. You see, nobody can do anything about drought. It's a general difficulty. It comes to the good and to the bad. It comes to preachers and to witches. Then Isaac sowed in that land and received in the same year 100-fold. And the Lord blessed him. How? How can you receive 100-fold harvest during drought? A miracle. I release the grace for miracles. May you experience miracles the months ahead of this year. You see, recently I was asking God, God, you said that 2020 will be our year of harvest and fruitfulness. Where is it now? With this corona thing. I'll tell you next Sunday what God told me about it. Then Isaac sowed. Look at verse 13. And the man waxed great. In one time. Give us NIV. Ah, I love this. You will prosper bad times by force. The man became rich. It's like drought was an opportunity for him to become rich. When others are borrowing, he's becoming rich. It's only a miracle that can do that. The man became rich and his wealth continued to grow until he became very wealthy. Give us New King James. I love New King James. Yes. The man began to prosper. That means he was not before. You can't begin if you are. And the man began. He was struggling and all that. God deliberately changed his life during difficulty time. Then the man began to prosper. God has that tendency. And continued prospering until he became very prosperous. That will be your story. Number four. Am I preaching correctly here today? Yes. Number four. Because of increased wickedness, you need the miraculous. Have you noticed that people have become more wicked than before? Even wickedness itself has increased. Yeah. It's not only people that are becoming more wicked. Wickedness itself is increasing. Yeah. The wickedness we see today. Hey. We don't have those records before. The only records we have is Sodom. The wickedness in the world today. Did you see the other day in the news? The wife coaching the daughter to lie that she was raped by the father so that the wife can be left to possess things. Yeah. Wickedness. Wickedness. Your daughter standing before the camera and saying, you raped her and you did not. Wickedness has increased. Today, we have children face their mothers and tell them, I am a mature person. I can give you a fight. Yeah. Wickedness has increased. You need the miraculous. Do you know the wickedness in the world today? Your children will not survive normally. They cannot. The system is wicked. Yeah. The other day there was a report that there was a school. The teacher during his lesson, he is exposing the kids. Grade 2 kids to pornographies. A teacher trained to be a teacher. And you see, you don't have your own school. You don't have your own school. You have to take your children to schools. You only need something higher than the wickedness. It's called the miraculous. I release that grace to you in the name of Jesus. Listen, as we get to July, you know, the Lord said that, and it's good for me to make this announcement. The month of July has been declared a month of prayer and fasting. And I'm telling you, you will see what will happen this month of July. The wickedness has increased more than any other time. The evils in the society today. Some, you are even afraid of mentioning them and describing them. The wickedness. Yeah. The brother doesn't think twice killing his own brother because of dust. It's like he will live with it forever. Now, what are normally the divine purposes of miracles? What are the reasons? Why? What is the communication through the miracles? What is God saying? What are miracles for? I've shown you why we need the miraculous in our day. Now I want to show you what the miraculous is supposed to accomplish. then we pray and we call it a day.
Number one,
the miraculous is God's system of supernatural bail out. It is God's system. Miracles are not just events, it is a system. It is God's way. It's God's way of supernatural bail out. You see, when you are arrested and you are taken to the police station, if you don't want to stay in the cells, you do what they call bail. You pay the bill. Am I correct? Is it the okay? Don't mind my grammar, but there is a difference. There is a bill and a bail. To bail, B-A-I-L, bail out, so that you can be taken out. The difference between the one for police and the one for God is that when you are bailed out from the cells, police custody, you are yet to go to the court. But when God bails you out, you are completely out. There are certain situations that you may find yourself in the journey of life. It's only the miraculous that can get you out. Am I preaching? Is somebody getting something? Yeah. It's God's system to bail out people supernaturally. The Bible says in Acts chapter 12, and therefore Peter was kept in prison. Nothing could be done. Nobody could get him out. Nothing. No wonder he slept. Naturally, you don't sleep in prison. How can you get sleep when there are chains in your hands and in your legs, and you are sleeping between the soldiers? There are only two theological perspectives. Perspective one is confidence in God. Confidence in God can make you sleep in the midst of challenges. Perspective two, hopelessness. He realized there's nothing that can be. Whatever happens, let it happen. Kama ni kukufa wacha ni kufa nikiwa nimepumzika. Yeah. Peter was therefore kept. There is nothing natural that would have saved Peter from prison. Look at the 16 soldiers taking care of one man who doesn't have a weapon. 16 soldiers. Nothing can get him out. It's only a miracle. And by a miracle, God bailed him out. And when God bails you out, nobody's getting you back. Look at what the Bible is saying. Exodus 3. I love this. Exodus 3 verse 19. Let's read this all of us. One, two, go. Let's repeat again verse 19. One, two, go. Verse 20. I can see Corona has really worked on us until we are not. Okay. Okay, let's read now verse 19. Give us NIV version. You see, if the church doesn't open soon, many believers will forget many things. They will even forget. Yeah. But I know that the king of Egypt will not let you go unless a mighty hand compels him. see that what my hand is. Verse 20. So I will stretch out my hand and strike the Egyptians with all the wonders. The wonders that I will perform among them. After that, he will let you go. I'll bail you out. Literally what God is saying here, I will literally take you out by my hand. How? By the miraculous. Whoever is watching this program now, no matter what the situation you are in, by the spirit of prophecy and by the anointing in this service, the anointing for the miraculous, may God bail you out of every negative situation. Remember, God told Moses in chapter 4 now. Chapter 4. In verse 17. But take this staff in your hand so you can perform what? Perform what? Perform what? Miraculous signs with it. For what? To get them out. It's God's system. The miraculous is God's system to get you out. May God take you out. Now and in the future, by the anointing in this service, may God take you out of any situation that is not favoring you. Number two. In fact, this is the main one. This is the main one. The primary purpose of the miraculous is for God to turn people to himself. That is the primary purpose of the miraculous. Any miracle that keeps people off God must be investigated. Miracles is God's system to turn people to himself. What are we saying? First Kings 18:36. The time of sacrifice, the prophet Elijah stepped forward and prayed, "O Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known today that you are God in Israel and that I am your servant." That's why we need miracles. Some people cannot believe you, no, even if you preach fire until a miracle happens. Some, not everybody, some people. So the man of God knows, "And I've done all these things at your command." Look at verse 37. "Answer me, O Lord, answer me, so that these people will know that, O Lord, are God, and that you are turning their hearts back again." The purpose of this miracle is not that people may know there is a great preacher around. No. The purpose of miracles is not to market you. What is supposed to market you is grace, not miracles. Miracles are platforms of advertising God, not advertising a preacher. Answer me. What should advertise you is what you carry. The grace. And that is where many preachers miss. They want miracles to happen so that people can go saying, "That man is powerful." That is not the purpose. "Answer me, O Lord." These people will know that you are turning their hearts to you. The miraculous is God's system of turning people to himself. Every miracle is programmed for several things. Number one, every miracle is programmed that people may see God through it. Every miracle is programmed after it has happened that people should be able to see God. Miracles are meant to make people see God. I'll repeat it again. Miracles are meant to make people see God. Some people will not believe the preachings. Some people will not believe organized and eloquent preaching. They will only believe when they see God in what he is doing in the miracles. And that is what I'm praying for the church at this season, that God will do things that will speak about him more than what we are saying about him. You can doubt words. You cannot doubt happenings. You can doubt what I am saying. You cannot doubt what you are seeing. The Bible says, Philip, no title, no nothing, went down to Samaria in Acts chapter 8. The Bible says that hearing and seeing the miraculous, the whole city was converted to God, including witches. Some people believe by hearing. Others believe by seeing. Miracles are programmed to make people see God. Number two, miracles are programmed to make people know God. To make people know God. Some people will never know God until a miracle happens. Number three, miracles are programmed to make people trust God. There is nothing that raises faith than the acts of God. There's nothing that raises faith than the miraculous. Listen, the effect of the miraculous is instant. It doesn't take process. It doesn't take time. The effects of the miraculous are instant. The Bible says, where we read in 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 39 now. Let's look at verse 39. When all the people did what? What did they do? What did they do? Yeah. They have been hearing the prophet talk. Now they saw the fire. What happened when they saw? They? And? What were they saying? No preacher. No preacher to convince them. Just one miracle. That is my prayer for you. That the miraculous will so manifest in your life that it will speak for God. The God you have been talking about. People to see God. People to know God. People to trust God. When you see a miracle for somebody else, you begin believing him for your own miracle. Because what he has done to one, he can do to all. It's a system to turn people to God. And what do we mean by turning people to God? People to see God. People to know God. And people to believe God. Number three, I'm winding up now. The miraculous is God's system to settle spiritual controversies. It's God's system. It's God's method. It's God's means. It's God's way to settle spiritual controversies. Remember the question the prophet asked them. How long will you waver between the two opinions? It's a controversy. Some people are saying The Lord is God. Others are saying Baal is God. Nobody has a proof to show who is who until the miraculous manifests. When the miracle happened, that was nobody, even Elijah did not ask them, are you still doubting? No. It is sorted out, it's solved, it settled the controversy. I am praying this period of Corona that God will give you a miracle that will settle controversies around your life, around your family, around the people. May God give you a miracle. Are you expecting a miracle? You see, I was telling God, this messenger, you would have said that it's my own message. You will not have me preach to people. Watch me. Watch me and see what will happen after now. And I will make sure that I give you my own testimonies. Settling controversies. Controversies are the most difficult things to deal with. Because controversies are is about two equal opinions. And nothing to make one stand out. That is why it is a controversy. And what happens is that when a miracle happens where there is a controversy, the sign that experiences the miracle stands out. The questions are answered. How long will you waver between two opinions? If God be God, let's worship him. If Baal be God, let's worship him. But there is nothing to show who is who. That was the problem. Sometimes you don't blame the people. Who is who? Who is who? This God we are hearing about. And people, listen, people are easily attracted and won by what they see than what they hear. I'll say it again. People naturally are easily attracted and won by what they see than what they hear. Don't blame sisters if they are following a man because of a car. The car is saying something. The car is saying no bonda bonda anymore. So don't blame them. Don't be quick to blame them. If you are in their position, possibly you will be worse. Oh, am I preaching correctly today? Please, can you say amen if you are here? Yeah. When there was a controversy, you remember when Moses was sent to Egypt and he went and dropped the rod, and they said, just the rod, we are also used to it. And they brought, you know, that was miracle one. The miracle one was challenged. It became a controversy. You have dropped a rod, it has become a stick, it has become a snake. We also drop our own, they become snakes. What's the difference? And Moses is saying, oh, I'm not used to controversies. And this is how the controversy ended. All their snakes were swallowed. Have you seen a snake swallowing other snakes? Doesn't happen naturally. And these are not ordinary snakes. And the snake that has swallowed all the snakes became a stick again, and he took it. That means we are not in the same class. And they kept duplicating what God was doing. To some extent, God said, I'm tired of duplication. So he did something, and the Bible, at some point, they came to Pharaoh and said, now this one, we can't duplicate. This is the finger of God. Oh, I'm not sure somebody is excited the way I'm excited. It's a God's, the miraculous is God's system to settle controversies. So anytime you see a controversy somewhere, pray for the miraculous to manifest. Not argument. Argument doesn't, you don't win anywhere through argument. You can't win by argument, but you can win by the miraculous. Oh, are we preaching right? Number four. It's God's system for the supernatural victories. Some battles you cannot win in any way. And you see, God wants you to win certain battles. And there is no doubt in your mind that it was God. I'll say it again. God wants you to win certain battles. And in your mind, you have no doubt that it was God. When the people look at it, they know this was God. That's what happened in Judges chapter 6 and chapter 7 about Gideon. He's going to meet the army with 135,000 soldiers. And he made the announcement, did the posters and everything. And all what he could gather was 34,000 soldiers. Look at that difference. 135 and 34,000. And God said, can you imagine 34,000 versus 135? And God said, you still have so many soldiers. What madness is this? Look at that. You still have many soldiers. And God said, can you announce anybody in this army, 34,000, anybody that is afraid, go home. He was left with, is it 10,000? Yeah. And God said, you are still too many. And look, you know that they are not many by looking at their opponent. The Bible says, he said, take them to the water. Take them to the water. Any soldier that focuses on his appetite, don't go fighting with him. Let them go home. They focus their appetite in other things, not in the warfare. But he that has the weapon in one hand and taking water with the other hand, then that is the man I want to use. A man that can do two things at the same time and still succeed. Am I preaching? Is God blessing us? 300 men against 135,000. You can't win there and say you are expertise. You can't win in that and still look at yourself and still point to yourself. You can't win in that kind of a battle. 300 men against 135 and still say, I know how to fight. You will point to God. You will point people to God. When people come to ask you, how in the world did you make it? You tell them, I don't know, but I know that God did it. And God is very excited when that happens. Am I preaching? Is somebody getting it? The last one. It's God's system for supernatural supply. The miraculous is God's system for supernatural supply, especially in bad times. Look. For 40 years, they never ate from the natural source. No farming, no market. And yet, they were eating every day. By the miracle, by the miraculous. 40 years, No buying new clothes, no buying food, no farming, and yet you have more than enough. One day they ate so much until it went through the nose. If you get what I'm telling you now, you'll be thanking God that despite how bad the economy becomes, with this you will have enough. This is the way to survival. A time is coming. Your Saturday will be nothing. I'm telling you, believe what I'm telling you. And I believe God is teaching you to know that there is something bigger than your Saturday. There is something bigger than business income. There's something bigger. It's called the miraculous. A time is coming. The economies of the world are getting to a place whereby, whether you have, let me tell you, the Bible says in the book of Isaiah that a time will come when the learning and the illiterate will have the same advantage. Do you understand what I'm telling you? And you see, the miraculous is that uniform. The miraculous is that uniform. When you fulfill the laws of the miraculous, it doesn't matter whether you went to school or you never went to school. It doesn't choose. And God loves because you can't intellectualize the miraculous. That's why sometimes when God wants to do very serious things, he will look for people that will not bring their intellect into it. Men like Peter, who has never gone to school. When God tells him, believe that Shando can heal, he just believes. He doesn't put science in it. Do you know why God chooses foolish things of this world? The Bible says, the Apostle Paul is saying, brethren, you know, it's not many noble, it is not many intelligent that have been chosen. Because God has chosen the foolish things. I'm trying to tell you that there are certain things where the world is going, you cannot have by labor. You can only have by miracle. There are certain supplies and provisions where the world is going. It's only those who believe in the miraculous will survive. I'm telling you. Am I preaching correct?
Look at Matthew 17:24. For supernatural provision. One day, they came
for tax in the crusades just to embarrass
Jesus
and his ministry. Just like today, one of the most prevalent spirits is the spirit of embarrassment. After Jesus and his disciples arrived in Capernaum, the collectors of the walikuwa na wangojea. Ulimwengu inakungojea, my friend. Wamefika hivi. Walikuwa. That means they had done all the arrangement. They knew their movement. They had known everything. So after Jesus and his disciples arrived like this in Capernaum, the collectors of the 2 drachma tax came to Peter and asked, your teacher, and look. And so spied them, they knew Jesus, Peter, they had no money that day. Judas, we don't know where Judas was. But the Bible shows us there was no money at all. Your teacher, does he pay the tax? Verse 25. Yes, he does, he replied. That means Jesus, alikuwa behind alikuwa na arias. Analipaga, lakini kwa sasa mbona hajalipa? Alikuwa na arias. Do you have arias? Don't worry. The miraculous is coming. He does. He replied, when Peter, Mutuma, what are you laughing? Peter came into the house. Jesus was the first. Okay, verse 26. I think there are some people with arias. From others, Peter answered, verse 27. But so that we may not offend them, because they are looking for something. It's not money they are after. They just want to embarrass us. Jesus refused to address it in the crusade. You want to embarrass me in public? He refused. He did not talk about it in the crusade. That's why I learned something there. There are certain things, as a preacher, you don't talk about them in the stage. You deal with them in private. Jesus was very wise. He did not talk about it. He knew the tax people are here. He did not address them. He waited until they went home. He also went home and he started talking about it. He actually started looking for money at home, not in the crusade. He did not even tell them that he doesn't have money. Take the first fish you catch. Open its mouth. How in the world is money in the mouth of a fish? And not just notes. Not notes, coin. Fish don't eat metals. How did they get into the mouth of a fish? God put it there. A miracle provision is when you get supply in a way and from places that would not have happened naturally. The first fish, because you will catch more, but there is one that is carrying the supply. It has to be a miracle to get the fish that carries your supply. It has to be a miracle to connect with the fish that has your supply. It has to be a miracle. You don't find it on the ground. You don't find it on the field. It has to be a miracle. Let's stand on our feet. Do you want to get into the miraculous? Serious? I can see you people, you have forgotten the protocols of the church. Okay, because of this corona thing. Please lift up your both hands to the Lord and tell the Lord, Lord, I want the grace for the miraculous. I want to begin flowing in the miraculous. You have shown me that these signs shall follow they that believe. I want this band time, this band seasons, I want to flow in the miraculous. I want to flow in the miraculous. I want to flow. I pray for the grace of the miraculous in my business, in my family, in my social life, in my economy. I don't want to depend on my salary. My salary is too small. I can't do it. Lord, we don't want to move in the natural. We want to flow in the miraculous. The miraculous. The miraculous. We tap into the grace of the miraculous. We connect to the grace of the miraculous. We connect to the grace of the miraculous. Is somebody praying? Is somebody praying in the house? Is somebody praying? Praying in your working place, wherever you are watching from. Lift up your voice and tell the Lord, I want to connect this grace of the miraculous. The grace of the supernatural. The grace of the miraculous. The grace of the supernatural. The grace of the miraculous. Rekotoko shata. Latatatatatata. Shondi labagata bagada. The miraculous in my finances. The miraculous in my provision. The miraculous in every area of my life. the miraculous in my health. I want to experience the miraculous life in my health life. Shadoko tokota. Batala bakadi. Shekredebia rosori. Risatatatapata. I'm telling you, something is happening right now. There is a release of the supernatural. There is a release of the miraculous. The Lord promised me that this service is not only to give people notes, is to trigger the anointing for the miraculous, is to trigger the grace for the miraculous, and it is happening right now. It is coming to your house. It is coming to your house. It is coming to your life. The grace and the anointing for the miraculous. Kapasa katala bahadis. Let the miraculous flow. I stretch the right hand of God on behalf of the heavens. Let the anointing and the grace for the miraculous locate your people now, wherever they are, in their houses, in their working place, in their businesses, in their homes. Let the miraculous locate your people. Let your people connect with the miraculous and begin to flow in the miraculous. Kadabahasata lakata saparadas siprada kashota kolaba. Lord, I pray that anyone that will come into contact with this message supernaturally, let them experience the miraculous. Let the anointing for miracles begin to work in their lives, for their lives, and through their lives. Let testimonies of the miraculous be recorded. I speak a miracle in the life of that man, in the life of that woman, in their financial lives, in their businesses, in what they do. Let miracles begin to work in their lives. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the miraculous. Thank you for the anointing of miracles. Thank you for the grace of the miraculous. We connect to that grace. It begins to work for us. It begins to work in us. It begins to work through us. We receive it. We celebrate the Lord for it. The doer of everything good. Ladies and gentlemen, I strongly believe, according to what the Lord said, this message was not just a platform to give people notes. It was a trigger to get people into the miraculous. Congratulations.